for 10 years. And then the industry started to grow, and in the late 70s, we started working on plans to put a straw in Lake Lanier. It wasn't that. I was that smart, the council was that smart. The industry drove us to do this. So, by virtue of working on the Corps of Engineers, working with EPD, EPA, I spent many trips going to Mobile, Alabama, working with General Moore of the Corps, obtaining permits so we could get in Lake Lanier. A lot of work went into the planning and drawings of the original intake in Lake Lanier. The county, at that time, they had a county water authority. It was in operation for about 5 years, and it went broke. We didn't have enough customers. So at that time, the county took over the water authority and put it under the auspice of the county, so general obligation bonds to put lines all over the infrastructure of the county. When we reached, in 1987, we reached a territorial agreement where the city would serve a certain area, one-third geographical area coming in from South Bend, and the county had the other two-thirds. The city graciously gave up the privilege to have the sole authority to serve for South Bend because we knew we'd done good. So we agreed to sell the county starting out in 1987. We agreed to sell the county water for 98 cents a thousand gallons with a CPI, the annual cost of living, and today it's gone from 98 cents to 243. We entered into that contract with the county in 1987. In addition to the 87 contract, it's been amended a couple of times, and 1992 was amended for the county to buy sewer allocation from the city of Powell. So the city sold sewer allocation to Forsyth County for $3 a thousand gallons. 1992. Today, the county's selling some of that sewer allocation for like $20 a gallon. The city treated the county's sewer last year. You don't hear anything about that in the contract. But the city treated the county sewer allocation last year for $249,000. That's total. And that's going into the $32 million treatment plant that we have today. So how long would it take to get the city's enterprise fund revenue bill back up to take care of that? You don't hear anything about that. You can't hear about that. The 1992 contract with the sewer, the 1997 contract with the raw water, the city agreed whenever the county built the Antioch water treatment plant, the city agreed to sell the county raw water. Now that's raw water. Was we agreed to sell the county at cost. And the cost is the cost of labor and the cost of power, which is about 10 cents a thousand gallon. 10 cents a thousand gallon. And they at times get 14 million gallon a day. 10 cents a thousand gallon. If any of you have read anything like that in the paper, raise your hand. Anybody know anything about reading county buying water for 10 cents a thousand?
I had to find it.
I'd like to know where it was. I've never seen it.
I had to look to find it.
I'd like to see it. You got a copy of me where it is. I'd like to see where the county gets it for 10 cents a thousand. So, the city of Cummings has managed its water system over the years without putting customers in debt. Enterprise fund is not in debt. We don't We managed to take the capital improvements without setting budget. So when the county says that they're going to, that the city has tried to pressure them into doing a 25 or 50 year contract, we have had a meeting with them and talked to them and had a proposal. I know you've read that, because I have. I hadn't read the 10 cents a thousand gallon, though. I don't know what paper it was in, but the county might have wrote it down on a piece of paper and you saw it, but they didn't want anybody to see it.
You said you're hard to get a hold of because you don't have email.
I'm up here every day. I'm up here every day. When I deal with somebody, I like to look them face to face. The city of Cumming, a few months ago, thought it was time for the county to pay up with our enterprise fund had been depleted on the reserve revenues, and that money that the county owes the city of Cumming based on the current contract pay the pro rata share of any improvements done, and the county hasn't done that. It was 65% of what the county is using off the city's contract, off the city's water grant, and the revenue, the money would be approximately $11.4 million. And the invoice was sent to the county by the city's water and utilities department some months ago, and it hadn't had a response. So I think it's time for the 18,000 customers that are coming into Forsyth County to quit subsidizing and the county to pay up the city. And some of you might say, well, what does the county get out of the $11.4 million? They get the allocation of pumping up 265 million gallons of water a day if it's needed. We have a plant now that's capable of pumping 100 million gallons a day, and the county's 65% of that 100 million would be 65 million gallons a day. They have that option. Every how much water they need. Right now, the city of Cumming or nobody that's in Lake Lanier are permitted because of the water board with Alabama and Florida. So the rule of thumb is, if the county needs 50 million gallon water a day, or the city needs 20 million, you can pump that much if you can treat it. That's today, the way the market is today. Nobody, we don't need that. But we think our engineers and our planners and designers of our project on Lake Lanier thinks that this 100 million gallon of water will be enough for coming to Tri County build out with extreme measures that we've took to preserve water. We think that'd be a deal about coming to Forsyth County. So the county would be getting the 65 million allocation of water. Now, they can go build their own plant. They have options. And I have copies of their options. They can go to the Eddywall Reservoir River if they can get a permit and build a reservoir. $52 million. But that reservoir would only guarantee them $6 million gallon of water a day. So spend $52 million and only get $6 million a day. They got another option off of another location in the Eddywall River, which would be closer, that they could spend $41 million. This is their figures, not mine. They could go to the Chattahoochee River if it was able to obtain a permit. They could build a treatment plant for $35 million. Or they could run a water line and buy water from Gwinnett County to the tune of spending $13.5 million for a water line and pay $3.05 a thousand gallon for water, treated water. There's a lot of options at hand, but none of them are financially feasible. The county has spent money, millions of dollars, on drilling for potential water wells. They have talked about the quarry, the France quarry, on Ronald Reagan being a reservoir for water. They've talked about the Chattahoochee, they've talked about the Eddy Wall, and even talked about going to the Tennessee River, bringing down here. None of it's feasible. It's like I told Jeff Doerr when he came up. So, you know, the city of Cumming looks like it has the county over a barrel. I said, no, we don't have the county over a barrel. County. We are the county, South County. Born and raised here. We don't look at it that way. It doesn't matter where the county has a contract or not, the water's still going to flow. The city of Cumming's water budget is about $12 million. The counties, they paid the city $39 million last year for treated water, and they paid the city $269,000 for raw water, a little over $40 million all total for water, a little over $4 million. But yet their water budget is over $30 million, $35 million. So I would like to have a place where I could invest $4 million in a product and get over $30 million back from it. Sounds pretty good, don't it? I'm optimistic to a certain extent that things will be done. It always comes down to the 11th hour and we get things worked out. I don't have any animosity toward any commissioner. I think we can work it out. Hey, when you, I got a lot of people to thank. Heck, I'm getting old. I've been in politics 46 years and going on 71 years old. So, you know, I'm always an optimistic person and think we'll get things worked out. I think we will. But, because I believe in coming into town camp. And the city of Cumming has been very fair. We just haven't had a dialogue. The due diligence hasn't been done on their part. The commissioners seem to have a turnover pretty often every 4 years. And then you got to start over. It's like a revolving door. And we've got to start over with all the things that we've gone through over the years. So, this is to say that I can write the script of what's going to be in the paper tomorrow based on the meeting that they're going to have tonight, because it's going to be a bash coming night. And that shouldn't happen. So, by virtue of not having anybody on hand that can talk about what's transpired since the infancy of the City of Cumming Water System, and myself and the City Council have all been there, and we've been through it. And we've had emergencies over the years where the whole board of the city council has pitched in, myself, the city manager, and the employees to help provide water in certain emergencies to Cumming and South County. But I can say unequivocally that Cumming and Forsyth County has had a good 25-year contract without any interruptions. No lawsuits. It's held to test. And I feel optimistic that things will happen and things will get worked out. Basically, I think after the town hall meeting tonight and some of the tempers cooled down and some of the activists wants to say, well, maybe I've been looking at this all wrong. Maybe the city is not the big bad roof that some of us thought it was. We don't have the only dog in this fight that we want is the serve the people coming into Side County with water in Westwood. We charge the county $3.04 a thousand gallon for wastewater treatment. The market, the city of Cumming being a donut hole in the market that surrounds county is from $6 to $18 a thousand gallon. And the city of Cumming charges the county $3.04 a thousand gallon. And that's not what we discussed over here tonight. The discussion, according to the letter that I received, says we're going to discuss city contracts, which the sewer is in the contract, along with potable and raw water. But the sewer's not going to be discussed, according to the letter. So, I've given you the way the city sees it, the city's position on the water, and my doors is always open. I don't, any email that you need to be sent, don't send it. I don't have an email, but City of Cumming collects all my emails that come to City of Cumming. So anybody who wants to email and reference this can do it at the City of Cumming. Or they can come see me personally because I'm here every day, every morning. Any questions anybody have, I'll tackle any question. Anybody have any questions?
Any idea why the county has waited so long to try and get the contract renewed?
Question is, do I have any idea why the county has waited so long to get the contract renewed? Wish I knew. You'll have to ask them.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, sir.
There's a provision in the agreement for mediation. I reckon that will ever come about.
Well, as I said, I'm optimistic, Mr. Moore. I think after tonight's meeting, hopefully things prevail to give some common sense approach. You know, any issue that comes up, if you just use a little common sense approach to it, it can be solved. I think we all know what common sense is. We know right from wrong. Yes, sir?
Mr. Mayor, speaking of the mediation, I'm just... Oh, first of all, the $11 million that supposedly the county owes, I'm just your representative. So, but when is that due?
It's due within 30 days of invoice. Like I said, it's been 7 months.
So, what, it's not due at the end of the contract, it's due.
No,
in other words, why did you send
the contract? That's a good question. That went on for the whole period of time while we was redoing the intake over there, which was 2 years. The total cost of that was $700,000, maybe $800,000. When we sent the county a bill to pay up, they paid up within 30 days. So the same thing they done then, they should have done with this invoice, but it hasn't been done. And I might add, we, the city of Cumming, just didn't surprise them and send them an invoice to say you owe us this. The total 2 years that the plant was under construction, they were brought up to date weekly. I even carried commissioners over and showed them what we were doing, went through the plant, showed them the whole pump stations, the 900 horsepower pumps, electric horsepower pumps that pumps the water. They were aware of it, and we give them copies of all the plans and the ever bill that where we paid the county had it out. So they weren't surprised by this.
Well,
all of a sudden they're surprised.
Before
other question.
Before you all did the why didn't you insist on them giving you a written agreement, which is what the contract calls for?
Let me respond to that.
You will.
This is an emergency. We were out of water, and we would use emergency pumps to bring the water in, so it's an emergency to get the new plant done as quickly as we could.
Is there a reason for emergency?
Listen, I'm not going to argue the gun. I'm not going to argue the law again, but I'm telling you what this was. This was an emergency. And if we had waited on some intergovernmental contract, hey, we've been trying to get an intergovernmental contract on this water deal for 5 years. And it hasn't happened. So what's to lead you to believe that we would have gotten an agreement to build a $17 million plant over there when just yesterday, the day before, there were members of the county commission that goes to the EPD in Atlanta working to get withdrawal permits so they only have to deal with the city of Cumming, which is fine. But what's to make you think that this is not going to continue?
Did you go down to the meeting with the EPD?
I was called by the EPD director, yes, sir. I went down and at the request of the EPD director, yes, sir.
But and this, my understanding is that members of the, we've got a couple of members of the commission here, and it's my understanding, I think, that you've met with every member of the commission to talk about water. And to me, I think, you know, just looking at the law, I just, I'm agreeing with you. It's not a very complicated thing. It shouldn't take 20 minutes to
nothing. Nothing that common sense wouldn't take care of. Any other question? Yes, sir.
Respectful, sir. Jack Leeson, I'm a member of the, I work with Smart Growth, but I'm here representing myself as a concerned citizen. You may be aware, I've been doing quite a bit of research. I'm on the Municipal Water District's Board Advisory Commission, and I've been involved with water concerns. Respectfully, the 11th District Court of Appeals has dictated that the Army Corps of Engineers is to reassess its authority right now. And that authority basically is what volume of capacity that the lake is holding that they have the authority to disseminate in allocation. All that's being reviewed right now. That information will be released in June. Subsequent to that information, once they know that amount, be it 327 million gallons a day or 500 million gallons a day, whatever it is, they will then try and determine whether or not they can meet those allocation requests made in 2000 in various municipalities in the Georgia region. The methodology that's being employed, my understanding, I've had a conversation with the Mr. Purcell, who's a Southern Region's lawyer for Army Corps of Engineers, explaining somewhat of their perspective to me, and a representative of the EPD. And the methodology that we're currently involved in finds the city of Cumming as superior, whose population demographics are a critical component in determining the veracity of our application. Part of this whole conflict going on with the Tri-State Water Boards is the other stakeholders in the southern part of the region questioning the veracity of our water supply allocation. And some of the the problem with ours is we have that overlapping of the city and the county, and they're not exactly sure. They had a problem, I guess, with Gainesville, you know, claiming a certain area and getting double the water or some kind of overlap or something like that. Would you entertain, what I understand is that if the city and the county could merge as equal partners in the infrastructure, and then the Forsyth County population demographics come at these commensurate instead of subservient, we would get the weighting of that situation better validates or justifies our allocation request out of the lake. This entire situation is very likely going to go to Congress because when they come to the Duke, they're not optimistic they're going to be able to meet the capacity of the current allocation we have, which is 37 million gallons a day and whatever one it has and everything like that, and still not have some kind of problem with power generation and keeping the muscles wet and everything like that. The ultimate solution, but granted things could continue the way they are, the city could contract water to the county. However, the methodology would make the best possible scenario if the two came together in ownership of the intake infrastructure commensurate. They would pay that $14 million or whatever, perhaps.
You want me to answer where the city would consider merging with the county? That's your question?
Not completely, sir. Not completely, just on the intake infrastructure.
Well, that would constitute the city-county consolidation, and no, I'm not for that.
It wouldn't dictate consolidation because that water would come out of the lake and then split just the way it does right now, and the city would have its infrastructure, and the county would have its infrastructure.
That's the way it is. The county's got their infrastructure.
Exactly.
For the intake.
But what
and they're going to have the allocation out of the intake. They're going to have 65% of it.
That's not.
And they're going to pay for that.
And they should.
And that's all there. We back.
But what I'm saying is, in the future,
yes, your statement.
Consideration for future allocations, we stand in a better light if you two can come together so that the population demographics are precise.
Unfortunately, the city hasn't put anybody in a bad situation. If we could just get the common sense approach, and I've been across the road many a times to try to discuss the issues over 5 years, and commissioners at that time said, oh, we got 5 years. We know you're no use to discuss these. And hey, if we don't have a contract, the water's not going to be cut off, as I alluded to. Steve?
Just going back to split 65% of that in operation, 65% of operational cost or maintaining.
No, it's 65% of the allocation. Any operational cost, the power, labor, just like it was if they owned their own plant. And they spent $52 million to build their own plant, they still going to have the operational costs. That'll be 65%.
It's a more of a capital improvement, not an operational issue. I mean, they paid for the pumping in with water down. They paid their 65% of that, but it's enough after water intake, brand new plant, that's more of a capital improvement.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. It's capital improvements or whatever you want to refer to it at, they're still operational costs. If you go out and dig a well, then you're going to have to spend extra money. You've got the water there, but you've got to have operational costs to pump, put a pump in it, pump water out of it. Those pumps over there that pump some water from 3,000 feet out in Lake Lanier, 3,300 feet, brings it into the cofferdam. 900 horsepower pumps it to the Antioch plant. It's not cheap to operate. They haven't paid any of the $17 million.
Mr. Clay, $700,000. A minute ago, you said that the county would have 65%. If they paid the $11 million, can you define what you mean by have? Because have, when if I told somebody that you can have something, that means that they're going to own it. Now, when you said that they'll have 65...
I'm not going to get into the legal aspects of it.
They have
allocation for 65% of what that plant does.
Okay. And so you're going to
get $100 million potential.
And you'll get 65%.
And they get title to 65% of what that produces.
But then, well, they get title to the infrastructure.
contract does expire, will the county raise the rates? Or will the city raise?
I can tell you, when the contract expires, May 26, the rates will change on raw water because it won't be no free run anymore. That 10 cents a thousand gallon is gone. The rates are going to change, be a drastic change on that. We're still going to require the county to pay the $11.4 million, and there'll be a change, drastic change on the wastewater treatment.
Do you know the amount you have approximately?
No, we haven't the utilities director with the engineers to do the water analysis of fees throughout the region and find out what the cost will be. We don't know that. Okay?
Can I make a proposal to you, sir? What if the county...
Listen, I appreciate every proposal that's come along, but the proposals probably needs to be made to commissioners over there. We're ready to...
That's the CP, sir.
Whatever, so, you know.
But they tell me, they went across the street and said, it's up to that gentleman over there, and he doesn't want to talk to us. I mean, that's, I'm reporting what they're saying. I wholeheartedly agree with you, Commissioner Sturgis. No, I've gestured that direction. Not a gesture towards you respectfully, Commissioner Bell.
I said basically what I want to say. I'll be glad if my doors are open to meet with anybody in reference to it. The news conference is over. Thank you very much.